Florida, Dr. Frank Walker. It's nice to meet you. Don't be frightened. I'm not going to eat you. I gave up eating people a long time ago. What's that? Oh, these? Ah, yeah. These are my hands. Well, they're mine now. They were somebody else's before. This is what you might call Professor Clemens' handiwork. Here, let me show you up close here. See that? It's the professor grafted two fresh human hands for me, as mine were not really doing too well. So he put on two nice ones, and they work perfectly. I don't really know what, I can only imagine what the other guy looks like. I'm sure Professor Clemens took real good care of him as well. So, enough about me. Heard that you might not be faring too well yourself. Is that correct? Well, that's why I'm here. Okay. What I'm going to do is just ask you a few questions, perform a little bit of a diagnosis, to see what might be ailing you. And then from there, we'll move into some treatments that I give my patients to help calm you and relieve you of probably what I think is bothering you and why you're here. Okay? I'm gonna check your heart, your breathing, your lungs, check your eyes, and then we'll move into some of the more professional methods, treatment methods. Okay, does that sound good to you? All right, okay. Trust me, you have nothing to worry about. You're in good hands. Okay. Well, so why don't we begin with a few questions, okay? Have you been experiencing any headaches? Okay. Any nausea? All right. Any dizziness? Okay. Are you currently taking any medication? Okay. Do you have any trouble sleeping? Are you experiencing any anxiety? Depression? Have you been diagnosed with depression? Okay. PTSD? Have you been diagnosed with that? Okay. Some of my methods have been known to act as an additional treatment to help those who've been suffering from these. Have you been experiencing any panic attacks? How about road rage? I know the commuting to and from work, especially some of the longer commutes, can often lead to road rage. Okay. All right. What about nerd rage? Are you a gamer? Do you find yourself, you know, raging when you get owned by newbie? Okay. All right, how about the family history of high blood pressure? Any history of that? Okay. What about heart disease? Does that run in your family? Any history of lycanthropy or vampirism? Yeah, okay. What about wetting the bed? It's okay. I used to wet the bed when I was a young human before I turned. It's perfectly fine. Okay. Have you ever been diagnosed with foreign bodies in the air, ear, such as teas, gravel, or slate pencils? Anyone ever, or you, ever put things in your ear like that? Okay. I'm going to do a checkup anyway. Make sure there's nothing in there. Ever been diagnosed with gangrene? Okay. Typhoid? No? Okay. Enlarged spleen? No? Okay. Cholera? No cholera either. Okay. Spanish influenza? No. Negatory? Okay. This is good. Any lacerations of the brain? Not that you're aware of? Okay. Gout? No? Okay. Flatulence? Yeah? Okay. How often? Okay. That's perfectly acceptable. Dysentery? No? Okay. Carbuncles? No? No. No carbuncles, okay. Piles? No piles, okay. And plague. Black Death? No? No? Okay. Because if you were diagnosed with that, I'd have to send you over to my buddy Corvus, but, okay. Alright, well, based on all of that information, and I do appreciate that you, answering, it seems like that you are pretty much healthy, average. You know, you're not suffering from any serious ailments, which is good. So, most likely what we're dealing with is a little sleep disorders, maybe some mental health issues, okay? Now, I'm going to try to help to calm your mind and help you get some sleep. I'll perform a series of some alternative methods, alternative medicine treatments, okay? These will help you to relax and get your mind into a more peaceful state, okay? All right, so I just want to perform just a routine checkup first before we get into all of that, all right? So I want to check your heartbeat. I don't really know why I bother putting this over here. This here is shot. But in any case. Alright, so just continue breathing as normal. I'm just going to listen to your heartbeat right now. Okay. Huh. You have a strong heart. I could tell. I could kind of tell that. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Alright, great. Alright, I'm just going to listen to your lungs now. So I just need you to breathe in deep and then exhale. Again. And one more time. Excellent, excellent. Check the other side. All right, I just need you to breathe in. Exhale. Good, one more time. And again. Excellent, excellent. All right, well, your lungs seem to be just fine. I don't really hear any fluid or anything like that, so it's not like you have a serious condition there to be concerned about, flu or anything like that. Okay? So, let me just move on here to the next little part of our happy little test. And I'm just gonna check your blood pressure, okay? So let's just wrap this around your arm here. All right. listen to your heart. Okay, just put this on your wrist here. Okay. All right, very good. Very good. You have a very normal average blood pressure, so nothing to worry about, no concerns there at all. At all. Wounded. So now I'm just going to check your eyes. Okay. Oops. That's not what I wanted. There we go. Okay. Alright. Okay. So, I just want you to follow the lights. Okay. I want you to stare straight ahead for now. Look right at my nose there, my beautiful nose, okay? And I'm just gonna check your eyes there. Okay. Just keep staring right here. Alright. Doing great so far. Okay. Just keep staring around. Okay, now I want you to follow the light this time with your eyes, okay? Right? Doing great there. Okay. That's it. Just follow the light. Doing just fine. There you go. Just wonderful. You're doing great. You're doing great. There you go. You're just getting straight A's across the board. I'll tell you. There you go. Best patient I've ever had, I think. Passing with flying colors. Okay. Your eyes seem good. So you seem to be in pretty good tip-top shape there, if I might say so myself. Okay. Alright, so I do want to check your ears, actually. And we're going to see if make sure there's no foreign objects in there. Okay. Let me just look in here. See what we can see. That's... Okay, it looks like there is something in there. Let me go check the other side. Thank you. Oh, something in here too. I don't know what you've been doing, but it's not really advisable to put things in your ears unless, you know, it was by accident. Let me get my little tool here. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to try to reach in your ear and see what we got in there, okay? Alright, so I'm going to be nice and gentle. See if I can grab that. What's in there? It's kind of difficult. Just try to get that, come on, there we go, just a little bit, alright, there we go, alright, I got it there, okay, well, looks like you had a rubber band in your ear. Remember how that got in there? No, you don't? Okay, well, no piggy. I've found worse things. There, we'll just put that there. Alright, let me check the other ear here. See what we got in here. Oh, this looks a little. Try to get that one. Okay. It's kind of difficult to. Try to get there like that. Almost. A little bit. Get that out of there. There. Okay. Well. It's like you had a paper clip in there. Were you trying to clean out your ears, huh? It's not, too advisable to use a paper clip, okay? I would not recommend that. Anything sharp or pointed, okay? So I would just try to stay away from that, okay? Putting anything in your ears. Ears aren't really a storage or meant for storage of anything except sound waves for feeding on receiving sound waves. Okay? Alright. Alright, last little checkup. I'm just gonna check your reflexes here. Let me just set this right. Okay. Alright, so I promise this isn't gonna hurt. Good. reflexes over here. Reflexes looked just fine, so no problems with that. Okay, so as I mentioned in the beginning, we're gonna start with the alternative medicine, alternative treatments that you won't find at your typical medical facility. Okay, something unique that we do here at the sanitarium, alright? And you might find some other doctors performing some of these techniques, alright? And some other licensed professionals. You might even see some everyday folks trying to perform these techniques, but it's not recommended. You really need to go to school for to do these properly, in order for the patient to receive the proper treatment and benefit. Okay, so let's see. So the first treatment we're gonna begin with is what I like to call here the big blue ball of ASMR of Arkham Sanitarium for mental rehabilitation. Okay, so, and you can see he's got a nice jovial expression. Okay, and all I'm gonna do is just tap like this. Doesn't that have a nice pleasant sound? Very comforting and peaceful. I think you might like that. So we're just gonna go like that. Okay. Just to try to get you to enjoy some nice sounds that have been proven to help many patients to reach a nice calm state of mind. It helps with their depression and anxiety. Just helps them to get some sleep. So that's all that I want to do for you. Okay, so you just enjoy it. You are in a safe place, sanctuary. You could easily interchange sanctuary sanitarium for sanctuary. Since you know that everything we do here is for your own benefit, your health and well-being. So, sanitarium, sanctuary, they're pretty much one and the same as far as we're concerned. Now what I'm going to do is let's see, how would you like some plastic? Would you like that? I have this big wad of plastic. I think you might enjoy this, okay? I know our my last patient enjoyed it very much. So I'm just gonna crinkle this giant wad of plastic. Your ears. Actually, I'm going to do each ear together in unison, okay? There we go. You just enjoy that sea of crinkle. Imagine you're floating over a landscape of pure crinkles of plastic, an ocean of plastic, such a wonderful sound. Bottom. such a nice sound. It's like an ocean of crinkles. Giant wad. Offers a nice soothing sound. What I can do is I can affect both ears in unison again. Fabric sounds, cloth sounds. These are bandages, so they already symbolize healing. And healing is what I want to do for you. Help heal your mind through mindfulness. Using these sounds to create a very pleasing atmosphere that is conducive to relaxation and sleep. And when your mind is at rest and is not worried, and when you sleep, of course, you heal. And each moment that you heal is another moment away from that which has plagued your mind. So, you just want to. I just want to. Well, we here at Arkham Sanitarium, but I, Dr. Frank Walker, wants to help you to achieve a state of nirvana, mental nirvana. I know I've been saying nirvana quite a few times now, and that's because I am big fan of the group, even though Kurt Cobain is no longer with us. God rest his soul. I have to say, as much as I like a fan of Incesticide and Bleach, those are my favorite. They're not as I guess you could say heavily produced as their last two albums, but I digress. These have some very nice sounds. I hope that you are enjoying these nice soothing sounds, and they are helping you to relax and sleep, and maybe even induce that sensation that so many feel. That tingling sensation. Put on some gloves. I think you might also like these sounds too. that's gonna end it for the gloves. I think I like those. How about some Pestle Mortar filled with salt, okay? Just gonna grind up that salt here. And just go. There we go. Think you might like this. It's very soothing. I think you're responding well to this. To most of the treatments, it seems like. Then I can always just tap on it. just give you a nice brain massage, okay? You've already been prepped and already removed your scalp, your top of your skull, and your brain is exposed. And don't worry, by the time that you wake up from this treatment, we'll have your skull back on, nice and sewn shut, okay? But I'm gonna give you a nice brain massage right now. It's gonna feel great, okay? So, just massaging your brain. There we go. Have such a juicy brain. So many folds. There we go. Just an extra way to help you relax. Get right to the source. That's what I always say. There we go. That's it. Just massage your brain. The frontal lobe. Get that one real good. The parietal lobe. There we go. Nice. Nice. Soothing. Brain massage. There we go. That's it. That's it. There we go. So relaxing, isn't it? Did you ever think that having someone massage your brain would be so wonderful? We pull out all the stops here at Arkham Sanitarium. There we go. There we go. Now, you may not feel me massaging your brain directly, but trust me, you'll feel a very relaxed state. I'm sure you already feel it already. You can hear me. You can hear the sounds of me massaging your brain. You just can't feel my hands or my fingers. Bit more. That's it. There we go. That's it. All right. Scrape off my hands. Next time that you want a brain massage, you know who to call, okay? All right. Let's see what else. Well, I think what we'll do is just end on some old dialect, ancient dialect. That some of us speak, and which is just some ancient language. It's not really used too much anymore these days. But anyway, it still serves a greater purpose. So we will do some of that. And hopefully this will put you right to sleep, okay? Alright, so I just wanna say thank you. It was a pleasure to meet you. And feel free to stop back anytime. And I'll be more than willing to help you to reach that more calm and state of mind, peaceful state of mind. All right, you just schedule an appointment with Dr. Walker, and I'll take good care of you, okay? So you take care of yourself, and I'm just gonna begin with the final treatment.